Field goal by three.
Fife, when you got a second.
Chris Sands has a powerful and accurate arm. He's a fierce competitor who will do anything to defend his turf today.
Seneca Wallace is a quarterback who can hurt you in and out of the pocket. He had a tough game last week in Oklahoma, but this weekend he's coming into our house with one thing on his mind.
Football Saturday in the great Southwest. One of the truly impressive scenes in college football. It's a Big 12 showdown in Austin, Texas. The 18th ranked Iowa State Cyclones and the 7th ranked Texas Longhorns. Here come the Texas Longhorns, ranked 7th in the country. A record of 6-1, trying to stay alive in the Big 12 conference title race. Folks, they believe with luck, they are still in the national championship title picture. Hi, everybody. I'm Tim Brand, along with Ed Cunningham. Glad to have you along for what should be a terrific matchup, especially with these two quarterbacks, big names, Chris Sims of Texas, and of course, Seneca Wallace of Iowa State. Both guys have lost to Oklahoma over the last 2 weeks, but Chris Sims against a strong K-State defense last week played well.
He needed something to get himself going. So much has been made about Chris Sims and his struggles against top 10 opponents. It continued this year in the Red River Shootout. He threw 3 interceptions, no touchdowns, and a game that Texas really had a chance to win late. Came back last week, and you made a good point, Tim, against Kansas State in Manhattan, Kansas, such a tough place to play. He didn't play spectacular, but he made some great throws down the field. B.J. Johnson really helped him out, put them in position to win with a field goal at the end.
Seneca Wallace had probably the poorest game he's ever played in his life last week. How does he respond?
Well, that's the big question. When you look at the game that he had against Oklahoma, it was the same thing that Chris Sims went through against the spectacular defense. 4 completions, 0 touchdowns, 3 interceptions. It was the entire offense's fault, but he just wasn't the same player. A lot of that had to do with the weather. Same weather today, very rainy. He has small hands, and that ball sometimes slips on him. But we cannot forget what kind of a spectacular player we have on the field today. This run, he goes 135 yards for a 12-yard touchdown against Texas Tech. And at that point, a lot of people thought he was number one in the Heisman race.
Well, is he still in that Heisman picture?
I think he is. Nobody has really set themselves apart in the Heisman race. And with the way the schedule sets up for Iowa State, some very difficult on the road games. I think if he can win today and continue down that stretch against those teams and play well, I think he's got a chance.
I couldn't agree with you more. Nobody really has stepped out and accepted the lead in the Heisman. Here come the Cyclones of Iowa State. On a rainy day in Austin, Texas, the focal point, head coach Mack Brown of Texas. He's with Samantha Ryan. Sam?
Well, thanks a lot, Tim. Coach, your running game has been off a little bit of late. Add the weather to the mix. It's been raining 3 straight days here in Austin. How does that affect your game plan?
Well, one thing, you look at Oklahoma and Kansas State's defense, that'll knock your running game off a little bit. Iowa State's got a great defense. We've been a little inconsistent, but we've got to run the ball and be more balanced. Take care of the ball and get more explosive plays today.
Now, you brought up Oklahoma. You can't get Oklahoma back. That said, how big is this game as far as Big 12 championship implications?
When you're at Texas, all of them are big. The only devastating losses at Texas are the losses.
Okay, thanks a lot, Coach.
Thank you.
All right, Sam, thanks. The final mental preparations begin. Psycho Cybernetics. It's Iowa State and Texas coming up. Daryl K. Royal, Texas Memorial Stadium for only the 10th time, Iowa State and Texas. It's rained the last several days here in Austin. More rain predicted this afternoon.
but this field drains well. Sand base, fast track, and solid. As you look at Dan McCarney, he's 22-10 since the start of the 2000 season. Quality coach. A 16-game home winning streak for the Texas Longhorns. Texas to kick off. Lance Young is the guy who wants his ball. Young back to the goal line. A yard deep. And here he comes. He's a speedster. Looking for a hole across the 20. And Iowa State out to the 24-yard line. Here's our first look at Seneca Wallace, folks. And he is special. Last year's Big 12 newcomer of the year turned into this year's Heisman candidate, hitting 60% of his passes with 11 touchdowns. He's run for six more, but oh, did he struggle last week. We'll see how he responds today.
Iowa State needs to come out and get some kind of rhythm going early for Seneca Wallace. I would not be surprised if they get a couple of little screens to their wide receivers. Just get his confidence back. He worked so hard in practice, but he's got to complete his first ball to have a good start.
First down, Iowa State. Straight ahead they go with Wagner. Not much there. Back to the line of scrimmage. Now let's take a look at our AT&T Wireless starting lineups. First, the backs and receivers. Michael Wagner is a tailback, averaging 4 yards a carry. Woodley is a throwback. Lane Danielson is the leading receiver and big play guy. Let me add a name here. They also come in with Montgomery. He has 26 receptions. Whitmer has 25. The offensive line averages 6'3.5". 300 pounds. Two of these guys moved over from defense, Shelton and Stubby. Butler is the leader and the team captain at center. Second down and 10. Montgomery's now in the game. Looking deep. Intended for Young. No good. Just out of bounds.
Outside receiver, they're just going to try to throw a little fade. Got the safety coming over the top. Dakari Pearson gets a nice shot and knocks him out of bounds. Good call by the official over there. Lance Young not able to get his foot in bounds.
So it brings up third down and 10 for Seneca Wallace. Backside pressure steps up. It's complete to Whitmer. He'll be close to the first down, and there is a flag.
Looked like at the end of the play, the defender from Texas might have got a hold of the face mask of Whitfer as he was trying to wrestle him to the turf.
26th reception
personal
of the year.
Personal foul, face mask on the defense. 15 yards added at the end of the run. First down.
Good call by the official. Right over the top came Rod Babers and had a hold of Whitfer's face mask and drug him to the ground. That's why it was the personal foul. And a good early conversion for Iowa State. I don't know that Whitfer had the first down yardage on the completion, but they needed something positive to happen for them after that debacle last week against Oklahoma.
So they move the chains. Up near midfield at the 49. Out of the shotgun with Wallace. They show blitz from Texas. And come back and throw it back to where the blitz was coming from. So Hiawatha Rutland comes in, goes underneath the blitz area for the completion and another first, a gain of 11.
And if you watched Iowa State last week against Oklahoma, this is what Oklahoma did all day. They brought two safeties from the weak side, and Brandon Everidge had a great game. Watch, coming from the outside right here, you got two defensive backs coming, and what a great play fake by Seneca Wallace. Releases Rutland to the outside. That is a great pickup by Iowa State and made Texas pay.
Wallace again with time, throws a dart and overthrows his intended receiver, Jamal Montgomery. AT&T Wireless lineups defensively for the Longhorns of Texas, a 4-3 scheme, one of the best D's in the country. Corey Redding is a 6'5", 270-pound quarterback hunter. He's got 17 career sacks. The All-American coming off his best game of the year. The linebackers are good with bad intentions. Derek Johnson is the team's leading tackler. Boyd and Jackson are second and third. In the secondary, Person leads the conference with 5 picks. Second down and 10. Absolutely nothing for Michael Wagner. Tackle made by Wright.
Roderick Wright, a true freshman. Got a bunch of playing time when Marcus Tubbs was down. Right here on the center, does a nice job getting inside. That was a missed assignment by the left guard, Bob Montgomery. But this true freshman got a lot of time with a couple of guys banged up. He's getting better and better as the season goes along.
Third down and 12 for Iowa State. Danielson in motion. This is where Wallace is the most dangerous and throws it away. Lee Jackson and Michael Huff came with the pressure. Wallace very wisely throws it away. No one was open.
Well, and you know, this was part of the game plan that Oklahoma used against Iowa State, was to blitz more athletic guys instead of bringing just linebackers, because linebackers are not going to catch up with Wallace. You bring smaller, faster guys, and he can't get away from them. Good plan.
Tony Yelk comes on to punt, and there's a look at Nathan Vasher, and he is dangerous. Look at his numbers. This is an end-over-end kick that will hit inside the five and roll into the end zone for a touchback. So a 42-yard punt, no return. Yelk does his job. Although he tried to pooch it, he'll bring it out to the 20, and that's where the Longhorns will have first down. So Chris Sims, a 6'5", 225-pounder, comes on. He's 21-5 as a starter. He's thrown 44 career touchdowns, 12 this year. And he led this conference in pass efficiency his sophomore year. Coming off a solid performance, as Ed mentioned, against Kansas State.
And I think there'll be a major difference between these two quarterbacks in this weather. When you shake Chris Sims' hand, it's like shaking a catcher's mitt. The weather and the rain should not affect his throwing motion as much.
Benson breaks it big. First down, Texas. A gain of 14.
Right up the middle. When we talked to Cedric Benson yesterday, he said we're going to go try to go right at the heart of this Iowa State defense. And Benson, who's been nursing a little bit of a turf toe since two-a-days, not quite 100%, but that time he didn't have to make many cuts.
Here he is again. Breaks through the line of scrimmage. Another first down. Well, Mack Brown said they had to run, and that's exactly how they're starting, a pickup of 16. Backs and receivers. AT&T Wireless starting lineup. Cedric Benson is the running back. You've seen him already. All-American. Trissel, the fullback. Edwards, the tight end. Johnson and Williams could be the best here ever. At Sloan, boy, you've got big-time players. Offensive line averages over 306 pounds. Derek Dockery at 345, the biggest and the best. First down, Longhorns. Again, it's Benson, left side. Pulls his way across midfield into Iowa State territory. Defensively for Iowa State, Jordan Karstens anchors that front four, former walk-on who is now the MVP. The linebackers are led by Brandon Brown, a young guy who's having a big year. Word led the team in tackles last year. He's second now. And in the secondary, Austin Billups and Hobbs are all former running backs. Mark Timmons is a talented safety. Second down and six. And again, it's Benson. Big hole. First down. Inside the 40 to the 36-yard line. Big blocked by Holloway and Dockery. A pickup of 12. A
little delayed draw this time. Really nice blocking up front. One of the problems Texas has had. They're 84th in the country in total offense, a lot lower than they've been in the last 3 or 4 years. And one of the problems this offensive line has had so many guys banged up. They haven't been able to play together and have been very inconsistent. And right now, they're taking it to the Cyclones.
Four carries, 44 yards for Benson. He set a bucket full of freshman records last year with over 1,000 yards rushing. The fake to Benson. Sims avoids the blitz and hits Williams. Roy Williams inside the 30 to the 29-yard line.
Take a look at the offensive numbers for Texas against the defensive numbers for Iowa State. 354 yards. They're 10th in the Big 12. Baylor and Kansas are the only two teams in this conference offensively that are worse. But 6-1, and the players talk about, you know, we really don't care what the numbers we're putting up. We're doing a good enough job when it comes to wins and losses.
Here's Benson again. to the 20-yard line. So they've gone 20 to 20 and continue to move. Matt Word made the tackle.
Greg Davis, the offensive coordinator for Texas, has been taking a little heat around here because of those numbers. But, you know, these receivers have been hurt. Roy Williams, who severely pulled his hamstring against Houston, missed Tulane. He's not 100%. Sloan Thomas has a little hamstring thing. They just haven't had healthy guys to have their full complement of practice.
Second down and six. They try the right side. There's not much there. Good play by Tyson Smith. This is an experienced defense, and they run to the football quite well.
Yeah, it was kind of, when I looked at the film yesterday, you and I were both talking about, we're used to seeing these Iowa State teams where they just kind of have big, loping guys. John Scodani has put together, through recruiting, some very athletic people that run very well up front.
A chilly, rainy afternoon in Austin. Feels colder than it is. Sims, timing pattern, and he has it complete to B.J. Johnson.
Yes, David.
Johnson's down inside the 15.
It's awful close, but I don't think there's a decision to be made. If it's fourth and inches, the way they've been pounding Cedric Benson, they've got some momentum. But this is not a first down. Do not expect Dusty Mangum to come strolling off the sideline for Texas to kick a field goal.
It is so hard to jump on top of Texas here in Austin. 16 home wins in a row, fourth longest active streak in the nation. Just that far.
Yeah, just pound it. Absolutely pound it. Ivan Williams is in there at fullback.
Here comes Edwards. Brock Edwards is 6'5", 250 at tight end. They'll load up, go heavy, try to bull their way in for the first.
You can get a little sneaky here, too. You've got some momentum. You've already got good field position.
Don't get greedy.
I always like to do a little play action, though. Try to find Roy Williams one-on-one up top.
Ivan Williams and Cedric Benson in the backfield straight ahead. They go for the first down.
I mean, this is the right call. Just pick up the first down. Just having a little fun thinking maybe fake one in there to Benson. You had Roy Williams one-on-one with Iowa State crowding around the line of scrimmage expecting some type of inside play. And Chris Sims, you kind of forget sometimes how big a guy he really is. I mean, he's 6'5", almost 230 pounds. He's going to get in behind those big fellas and pick up whatever you need.
They can still get a first before they score. Here's Benson, right side. Haven't had much luck going that way toward Brandon Brown, number 33. He's a leading tackler, active, confident, and gets into the hole quickly. Just skates down that line, inside out.
When we were talking this week to Greg Davis, the offensive coordinator, about this Iowa State defense, he said he put in the Nebraska tape and he was disheartened with how well these guys ran to the ball. You watch that film, and this is a very athletic front for Iowa State, but the game plan for Greg Davis, very obvious. They're going to try to pound Benson and soften him up.
Here's Benson inside the 10. Look out. 5. Down to the 3-yard line. Mark it at the 2. Cedric Benson, a pickup of 12.
1-yard gain, 1. First and goal from the 1.
Well, you mentioned they hadn't had much luck getting going on that right side, but this time hat on a hat, and Tillman Holloway, the left guard, absolutely buried Jordan Karstens, the nose guard, and that was what Cedric Benson needed to cut off of.
8 carries, 60 yards on this drive for Benson. Right side, Benson, touchdown Texas. The Doak Walker Award candidate. Awfully strong to start the game.
Well, there's no mystery. First drive told us what we're going to see in this rainy weather. This offensive line pounded straight ahead and try to take advantage of the size of this offensive line of Texas.
Well, you saw the record for Mack Brown when Texas scores first. They're on the board. The extra point is good. And the Longhorns jump out on top of Iowa State. 7-0. What a drive. Cedric Benson with a 1-yard plunge, 63 yards on that drive. Texas on its first drive goes the distance, 80 yards. Benson had 63 of them and pulled his way in for the touchdown. So Cedric Benson off to a quick start. Texas on the board first. And Adam Beneke to kick off. But Michael Wagner and Lance Young. This will be Young at the 5. Off the 20 to the 26-yard line. And spectacular drive by Texas to start things off. Let's go to the instant recall and take a look at Benson on that drive.
Very early on, they established just straight-ahead isolation plays, a couple of little delayed draws, and Benson, who admittedly is not 100% with a little bit of a turf toe that's been bothering him since 2-a-days, let this big offensive line. He had 61 yards on 9 carries. That's the most he's had in the last 2 ball games.
He was virtually untouchable on that drive. Here's Seneca Wallace with a lot of company. He's got a run, does. Breaks a tackle across the 30. Seneca Wallace to the 41-yard line. They'll mark him almost the 43. A gain of 16, and there are the feet of Seneca Wallace.
And here is his mirror today. Derek Johnson, the weak side linebacker. His job today, he is the most athletic linebacker that Texas has, is to mirror Wallace, and Wallace runs right by him. And Derek Johnson's a great player. He had a great freshman year. He was Big 12 freshman of the year with Tommy Harrison of Oklahoma. I think that they need to get a safety track in this guy. There's no linebacker in the country who's going to be able to keep up with him.
Good point. DJ, 6'4", 220. Wallace, 5'10", 193, and quicker than Gossip. Here's the pitch back to Wagner to the 45 up near midfield. Knocked out by Michael Huff.
Take a look at the offensive numbers for Iowa State against a very good Texas defense. Those passing yards for Iowa State way down after only 40 yards passing against Oklahoma. They were up around 300 yards a game. But Texas, one of the very best in the country, and they have been so good. They have. The opposing quarterbacks have only completed about 42.5% of their passes against this Texas. That's the best in the country.
How about this fact? This defense for Texas has forced 3 and out almost half the time, 47%. That's phenomenal. They need 4 for the first. Danielson in trouble. He's going to lose yardage. A loss of 6. Lee Jackson, the linebacker, got there first.
And Seneca Wallace got to check out of this play. He knows what he's got coming back. And they've got 2 blitzers coming from this side. They've shown it 3 or 4 times. Seneca's got to check out. You have to know where your pressure is coming from. You saw it all last week against Oklahoma. That's a dead play, and he needs to get out of it.
3rd down and 11. Showing blitz again. Huff is coming. Wallace rolls, throws. Dart to Whitmer. Should be enough for the first. How about that big time play?
Yeah, and this is what all the coaches, Carl Reese, the defensive coordinator for Texas, Steve Bricky, the offensive coordinator for Iowa State.
He throws this on a rope.
Yeah, and they all say that he's one of the best they've ever seen throwing on the run. And he doesn't have to set his shoulder, square shoulder, set his feet. And that's a little unusual. A lot of guys, when they're rolling to the right, and he's really good even to his left, they have to set their feet. Well, he can really throw it accurately on the run.
Well, the tackle for the loss by Lee Jackson had him backed up. Wallace gets him out with a pass to Whitmer. Here we are, 1st down. Wagner, big hole. Breaks it inside the 35, move the chains, another 1st down. Big block by Montgomery that time.
Michael Wagner and Hiawatha Rutland are kind of the two-headed monster back there. And these coaches just decide this is just nice blocking up front by Iowa State. What a nice little seam right there for Wagner to run through. And he finishes the run so very well here at the end. And these coaches will decide as the game goes on, who do they want in there, Rutland or Wagner? Wagner's in there fighting to be the guy.
Iowa State has moved the ball efficiently, effectively, but still no points. Wallace, 3-step drop, timing pattern, intercepted. Nathan Basher with his second interception of the year. On the slant pattern, he read it and picked it.
Basher, another guy who's been fighting some injuries. He sprained his ankle against UNC. Watch him squat on this man-to-man right here. Gets his hands. Boy, that's just great technique by Basher. Work on one-on-one with Lance Young. Not 100% healthy on that ankle, but that's great technique.
So still no points for Iowa State. The big interception by Basher. And Chris Sims bring the offense back on. ABC Sports presentation of college football is brought to you by Chevy Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. AT&T, welcome to M-Life, AT&T Wireless. By Chili's, like no place else. And by Bowflex, for real fitness results. Bevo's pretty fit for being as old as she is, or he is. I don't want to insult her.
18 years
Bevo,
old.
Yeah. Bevo looks great. We had a chance to spend some time with Bevo yesterday.
Got a little frisky behind us a few times with those horns.
What's 18
nervous.
Years old translate into? Steer you.
Is it like dog years? About 75 something?
Here's the end around to Roy Williams. Well, it continues to rain, and the one who's taking most of the rain is Sam Ryan. Hi, Sam.
Hey, guys. Easy to say that up in the press box. Now, three straight days of rain here in Austin. One would think the field would be a mess. Look at this. It's really not, because they use the PAT system here for easy drainage. You don't see water coming off. Now, underneath the grass, you have 12 inches of sand for the drainage, then a plastic liner. It all empties into a 2,000-gallon type through drainage pipes. Now, through the computer system, the grounds crew can see just how much water is on the field, how much is in that 2,000-gallon tank. Only a handful of college stadiums actually use the system. It runs about $1 million, guys.
$1 million. Well, it's paying off today on this field. And, Sam, that's a great report, because those pumps work, especially with a sand base.
Yeah, they have that at the Orange Bowl.
Well, the ball is still dead. False start on the offense. 5-yard penalty, stay second down.
Did a game at the Orange Bowl a few years ago. They have basically the same system, an older system, obviously, but was down on the field. It's amazing how quickly that water draws out. The ball will still get wet, though, and that's the key. And Seneca Wallace, we've seen with those small hands a few times already, that ball slip out, but the ground is great.
When they started with prescription turf, they had the grass, soil, and then chicken wire for the root system, charcoal, and then the sand to drain the fields off.
Is it Dr. Sod that gives that prescription?
Unbelievable. Now they've gone to these pumps. Here's Young. Selvin Young with a big pickup. Should be enough for the first. It is. Gets good mark. First down, Texas.
Selvin Young, a young guy, came in as a true freshman. Was so good in two-a-days. Ivan Williams is in there starting at fullback for Matt Trissel, who's a little banged up. So good. He's learning. You know, those young guys, they come in a lot of times, they want to bang everything to the outside and try to outrace everybody. He's slowly learning how to be patient and take what's there. That was a nice little bob to the inside and cut to the outside that time.
Young takes the pressure off Cedric Benson. He averages 5 yards a carry. Picks up 11 there. First down, Texas. Sims to Williams. Great catch. First down. I want to tell you something, folks. B.J. Johnson, Roy Williams, Sloan Thomas. This is the best trio of receivers in Longhorn history. 65 receptions, over 1,000 yards already this year.
And here's one of the things that John Spladani, the defensive coordinator, was so worried about. They've got such small defensive backs at Iowa State. Ellis Hobbs, who was on the coverage there, 5'7". Roy Williams, close to 6'4". And he knew coming in, he said, Florida State had good receivers, big guys. These guys are bigger, faster, and stronger than what we saw against Florida State.
Gain of 19. Here's Selvin Young. Breaks two tackles and a gain of 8. Selvin Young, the true freshman from Houston, showing some quicks.
There's three receivers, juniors. That's a true freshman, Selvin Young. Just mentioned what these guys have done. Sloan Thomas has been a guy not as productive as the other guys, but he's made really, really big plays down the field. Roy Williams, a couple of yards, is over 2,000 now for his career. Both Roy and Sloan with those hammies, and BJ's been the guy who's kind of picked up the slack.
Sloan Thomas came in as the leading receiver, though, with 22 catches, and Williams with 21 and Johnson with 20. Now, we hear all this talk about that being the best trio ever. Do you agree?
Well, there was Lavelle Pinckney and Adams a few years ago that were pretty good as two. But, I mean, for three guys, all of these guys are probably guys who are going to play on Sunday with their size and speed. And, you know, Mack Brown made an interesting point that this is a conscious effort for them in recruiting to look for bigger players. When he was at UNC, they got tired of their short corners getting beat by tall receivers. So they said, well, let's start recruiting taller guys at that position.
Mentioned the NFL as Chris Simmons calls timeout, but the office was full of NFL scouts. NFL scouts everywhere this weekend here in Austin, Texas. So Texas takes a timeout. Longhorns still lead, 7-0. Rain continues to fall. Dry clothes are needed everywhere. 3:34 to play, first quarter. Iowa State trailing by 7, and Texas threatening again. At the conclusion of today's game, we will select a Chevrolet player of the game. Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund. Third down and 2. Benson, the lone setback. Ace formation. Benson, first down. Breaks a tackle, still on his feet inside the 25. Cedric Benson with a gain of 10. Plays bigger than his 6'205" frame.
And the one thing you and I were talking about, yards after contact, and Benson is so good. He doesn't get a whole lot of yards after contact on this one, but he fights through at the very end. He keeps his legs going, and he was talking about his shoulder pads and how when he sees somebody coming up in their shoulder pads, 59% of his yards this year after contact, he wants his shoulder pads lower than the defenders at all times.
Benson. Inside the 20. Ball loose. Iowa State has it. Brandon Brown came up with it.
Boy, this doesn't happen very often. Over 400 carries in Cedric Benson's career, and this is only the fourth time that he has fumbled. It's a little wet as he goes to trip. He actually fumbles, hitting the back of his offensive lineman, and you have to think, with the wet conditions, that ball is slippery in his hand. Ball not knocked out by Iowa State, but they'll take it.
Not only Benson protected the football, only his fourth fumble, but Texas protects the football as well as anyone. Plus 9 in the giveaway takeaway.
Boy, and Iowa State really needed this. The momentum was getting a little ugly for them.
Hiawatha Rutland around the left side, picks up 5. So Cedric Benson on a wet field, as Ed said, only his fourth fumble and 409 carries.
Bruce Chambers, their running backs coach, talks about carrying the ball high and tight. Get that arm pulled up around the chest, not down around the ribs. But that time, you just have to wonder, as he ran into the back of his offensive lineman, if the ball being slick was not the cause of that fumble, because it wasn't a hit, a helmet, or anything like that that got it out.
Wallace with plenty of time. Looks to the sideline, incomplete. Terrific play out on the corner by Babers. Rod Babers just swatted it away.
Saw this a little bit last week against Oklahoma. That ball floats on Seneca Wallace because he had Whitford open there for a moment, and he just got too much air under Babers. Great closing speed to knock it away.
Wallace just 3 for 8, 34 yards.
I just don't think that his hand is made for this kind of weather. That ball, that slick ball, is hard for him to get any kind of spin on it to get a tight spiral.
Third down and 5. Wallace needs help. He's close to a first down. Ball's loose.
Oh, he was down.
Iowa State gets it back, but he's close to a first down. He is so talented. Boy, those feet.
No.
Tap dancing on a light bulb just through that hole. And they'll measure.
It has to be so frustrating to try to tackle this guy. Watch how many moves he makes, but he's always moving forward right there. He almost broke the ankle of the middle linebacker, Reed Boyd. Boyd's left ankle nearly gave out. He got juked so hard on that play.
Montgomery and Danielson come out wide on the draw play.
He's up, guys. He's up.
Hiawatha Rutland gets a couple of tough yards. They'll give him three. It'll bring up seven.
Well, you get the feeling that Steve Bricky, the offensive coordinator for Iowa State, starting to get a feel of what Texas's plan is. That time, Reed Boyd, the middle linebacker, going straight to Seneca Wallace, expecting some kind of quarterback run, and he ran right by Hiawatha Rutland on the underneath handoff. And I think what they're trying to do is take advantage of this aggressive game plan of Texas with a little bit of delay in their package.
They need seven. Wagner and Rutland in the backfield with Wallace. Throws a strike for the first down to Danielson, and Danielson's up near midfield. His first catch of the game, 30th for the year.
You know, Tim, we were talking about how well Seneca Wallace throws on the run. He is so accurate when he throws on the run. When he gets out of that pocket, and for a guy who's this athletic, most guys, when they get outside of the pocket, do not keep their eyes downfield. Watch his eyes as he gets over here to the right. He's looking downfield. He's just buying time to throw it. He is not interested all the time in tucking it and running.
Absolutely nothing for Hiawatha Rutland. Reed Boyd just met him in the hole. Big old number 11, DJ. Derek Johnson was there as well. But Boyd, a hard-working, tough fourth-year linebacker, was there first.
And these linebackers filling in for some great ones here at Texas. 110 career starts between Everett Rawls, D.D. Lewis, and Tyrone Jones, the three guys that started last year and the year before. But they have some athleticism.
Boyd now was the backup linebacker to D.D. Lewis. Now he's the man. That's the end of the first quarter. Our presentation of college football will continue after this message and a word from our local stations. You're watching ABC Sports. The rain in Texas continues. 15 at Memorial Stadium in Austin, Texas. A look at Dan McCarney and Mack Brown. Iowa State in Texas. 7-0 Longhorns. Seneca Wallace on second down and long hits Danielson, and Danielson will have enough for the first. Lane Danielson with his second catch. He averages 19 yards a catch. That one's for 10. Former walk-on, now all-conference guy. And how many times do you hear that story?
It's nice to see Seneca Wallace getting some confidence back after what happened against Oklahoma. And the same thing happened to Chris Sims. Both of these guys were cruising along, having great years. They ran into that great Oklahoma defense and both had horrible games. And Wallace needs a drive like this to get his confidence back.
Iowa State has moved the ball the entire game, just haven't been able to score. Wagner met in the hole rather rudely.
It's kind of interesting when you look at the years that Sims and Wallace were having before they played Oklahoma. And the amazing drop-off for Sims and for Wallace, 18% completions. He only had four complete passes, did Wallace against Oklahoma. They combined for six interceptions and no touchdowns. Oklahoma plays great defense. Wallace was just a little out of sorts a little bit, but they have such a good plan. Bob Stoops and Mike and Brett Venables, co-defense coordinators, they put together such great plans at Oklahoma.
Two quarterbacks threw a combined six interceptions against Oklahoma. Here's second down and long. Wallace with time. Now throws over the middle again. It's complete to Whitaker. Whitaker with his third catch, and Whitaker's one of those guys. Doesn't look like he's much. 5'10", 181, but always finds open areas.
And him and Lane Danielson, the walk-on program at Iowa State, starting to produce some very good players for Dan McCarney. And Whitaker and Lane Danielson, that's just very soft zone coverage. He just gets right in the middle there, sits down, and Seneca Wallace finding a little rhythm here, Tim. He's starting to throw the ball very well.
The option, Being chased down the line, absolutely nothing there. And here comes Corey Redding to tag him at the end. Corey Redding, an All-American defensive end, who is intelligent, congenial, big-time player, had some kind of game last week against K-State. He played his best game as a Longhorn with 2 sacks, 4 tackles for loss, forced fumble. This guy is a big-time player.
Unquestioned leader on the offense, Chris Sims. Unquestioned leader on the defense, Redding. And he talked about last week getting ready for Kansas State. He was quiet all week, didn't really talk to his teammate. He said, I didn't want to do it with my mouth. I wanted to do it with my game. And he showed up and played a monster ball game in Manhattan.
Backside pressure, throws again. Here's Danielson. A gain of 5. 4 straight completions for Seneca Wallace.
You know, you have to run plays based on who your personnel is that's on the field. And Steve Bricky right now is doing such a nice job using these guys. These Danielson, not the fastest guy in the world, runs great routes, getting underneath between where the linebackers are and the safeties and sitting down. And Wallace making very easy throws.
Big third down here. The out pattern complete, first down. This is Lance Young who makes the catch, and again they move the chains. A couple of those passes on this drive. Derek Johnson's having a tough time, as good as he is, having a tough time keeping up with the speedier receivers.
Well, and I think that's part of the plan right now, that Steve Bricky sees what the plan is, that Derek Johnson is such a big part of this plan for Texas. He's the mirror on Seneca Wallace, and then he has to play the underneath coverage. Right now, just getting to the outside. But Seneca Wallace, these are very easy throws, too. He doesn't really have to test his arm to make these throws.
And they give to Hiawatha Rutland inside the 5 to the 2-yard line. Down to the 1. But I'll say this about Seneca Wallace's arm. It's probably the most underrated arm in the country. He throws a great pass. Can almost count the revolutions.
And here is where he is so dangerous, down here around the goal line. When you have a guy like this, this is a nice job by the offensive line. Good job maintaining their blocks. And Rutland, if he doesn't slip.
He got a great mark because his knee touched out by the 5.
The officials
they
just
mark
corrected
it back there.
Yeah, they just corrected it. The officials had a little conference. If he doesn't slip, he might have gotten the end zone there. But that's what, this guy's so dangerous, Wallace, down here. You can move him out of the pocket through so many things.
They can still get a first. It's 2nd down and 4. Rutland, nothing. May have lost a yard. Great penetration on that line by Tubbs, Wright, and Boyd got there as well.
Well, now you got 3rd down. And you mentioned that they could, I mean, they've got about a foot between where the 1st down marker is and the goal line. But now you have to do something with Seneca Wallace. It's just stuffed right at the point of attack. Stevie Lee in there does a nice job, but they're going to have to do something here with Seneca Wallace on 3rd down. Cannot settle for field goals.
Get into the corner. They need 5 for the first. Throwing the timing pattern to the corner. Flag flies. Babers may get called for interference.
I don't like the play call, Tim. It's a one-shot deal. It's a fade route. If it's not there, it's not a touchdown. I mean, they're going to get the
pass
call here.
Pass interference on the defense. Foul occurred in the end zone. Therefore, the ball spotted at the 2-yard line. 1st down.
But with a dynamic talent like Seneca Wallace, the way he can run and throw on the run, I don't know that you want to try to just throw a one-shot fade. Boy, I don't know about that call. I mean, those both guys are getting handsy. Rod Babers.
Well, you know how I normally defend the defensive guy, but he gave him a shove when the ball was in the air.
Yeah, but the Whitford was doing the same thing.
Rutland runs into a wall. Derek Johnson with a stop. Let's go back to Manhattan and John Saunders. John, what do you have?
Well, Penn State has a couple of losses in the Big Ten. Both were in overtime. Ohio State unbeaten as of yet. Zach Mills, a little pitch to Larry Johnson. You see the power to get this one in. 5 yards on the touchdown, 7-0. Maurice Clarett, the freshman running back for the Buckeyes, out of the game with an injured shoulder.
Not the same team without Clarett in there. That Ohio State team goes from being one of the best to a mid-pack team without Clarett.
Talented Penn State team. Here's 2nd down and goal. Wallace with the pitch back to Rutland, and he'll lose yardage back to the 5. Great pursuit by an aggressive defensive scheme and Texas.
That's Kalen Thornton, who's just coming back healthy at ACL surgery during the offseason. They are so glad to have him back. Watch him string this thing out, working against the tight end out there. And he is no match on the edge. He's finally starting to get healthy. Again, third down. You've got to move Wallace out of the pocket. Let him do something with his feet and his arm.
Third down and goal. Wallace. Rutland. Inside the five. To the 3 yard line. Derek Johnson tracked him down and got him.
You know, it's easy to sit up here and second guess, but once again, I just don't understand why you want the ball out of this young man's hands. Texas, when you're playing the option, you have to get the ball out of Seneca Wallace's hands right away, and they did a great job of doing that and strung it out. I want Wallace with the ball in his hands as long as possible if I'm Iowa State.
Well, they tried, put him on the option, but Lee Jackson was in his face. Vanicky with a 19-yard attempt from the right hash. Good snap, good hold. And the kick is good, but there's a flag down at the 3.
Well, this could get interesting. If Texas was lined up offside, you get a half a distance to the goal, it's going to be about a yard for the touchdown. You have to wonder.
It's against Iowa State. And so they'll have to
kick
again.
Illegal formation on the offense. Not enough players on the line of scrimmage. 5 yards, repeat fourth down.
You know, when I was looking at that formation, it looked like a coach of mine used to call it the flying V. Everybody's kind of lined up. If those linemen are not breaking the belt of the center, they're not considered on the line of scrimmage. I don't think they were lined up properly.
See how unusual it is for penalties for Iowa State and McCarney's team, fewest in the Big 12. This will be a 24-yard attempt now for Adam Beneke.
Texas blocked 2 kicks last week, the one to win the game against Kansas State. I wouldn't want to have to kick this again with this Texas front getting penetration.
Blocked 3 last week and 7 for the year, and this kick is no good. So a great stop by the Texas defense, or Iowa State stopped itself with the penalty. How about this? Memorial Stadium is rocking. And that's why. 7-0. Take a look at our Chrysler passing playbook with Texas still leading 7-0 over Iowa State. Monday night, Al Michaels and John Madden will be in Philadelphia, where there will be no brotherly love between these two division rivals. Donovan McNabb and the Eagles take on Michael Strahan and the Giants Monday night, 9 Eastern, 6 Pacific.
Michael Strahan, 15 sacks against the Eagles. I still think that his record should have an asterisk next to it. We should credit one of those sacks to Brett Favre.
Cedric Benson, straight ahead. Tough 3. Tackled by Jeremy Lloyd.
Game plan does not need to change for Texas, but how frustrating for Iowa State. They've moved the ball up and down the field offensively. A mistake in the kicking game where they were lined up incorrectly cost them a chance at some points. Marty Fine, the special teams coach over there, could not believe that because they were misaligned, they had to take those 3 points off the board.
Second down, Texas needs 7. Sims throws to Benson. Terrific play on the corner by Ellis Hobbs, who read, got a great break, and knocked it away.
Sims trying to look downfield. The one thing that Texas knew coming into this game. Boy, that is a nice play by Hobbs to reach out and get that. Benson does such a nice job getting out of the backfield, but that's what they try to do, Iowa State, with their corners. They allow them to play a lot of underneath coverage and make you be patient because their safeties are giving help over the top.
Third down and 7. Cut, cut. Five-step drop, throws over the middle. Roy Williams can't catch it. It's picked off. This is Billups to the 35-yard line. Billups with the interception, his first of the year. Former running back, his last carries came against Alabama in that Independence Bowl, and he makes the pick and returns it 9 yards.
Well, and here's a guy, Jermaine Billups, as this ball goes right through the hands of Roy Williams. Got the defender dragging on him, but you get both hands on it, you either got to bring it in or knock it down. But Jermaine Billups, John Scudani had to talk him into playing defense because he wanted to play running back so bad.
Almost called him Chauncey, but that's his cousin. Hiawatha Rutland inside the 30. Flag flies.
Rutland, flag on the play.
Boy, it's got to be so frustrating for McCarney. We saw that graphic
holding
earlier.
On the offense, 10 yards from the spot of the foul, repeat first down.
How good they are with penalties, and now they're just really, really hurting any momentum they're getting.
Time now for the Aflac trivia question. In what year was Texas awarded its last national championship? And I'll give you a hint. They've won three of them. Not much of a hint.
Yeah. How does that give me a year?
Iowa State now with 12 first downs, 131 total yards, and 0 points. Continue to hurt themselves. Seneca Wallace rolls left. Looks back to the other side for Danielson. That ball was perfectly thrown down to the 21. Wow is right.
Yeah, that's beautiful. We'll give some credit to Lane Danielson on this one, too. I mean, that's a great throw by Seneca Wallace, no doubt. Kept the ball inbounds all the way back across. They set this up beautifully. They rolled, semi-rolled the pocket over there. And such a nice job by Danielson running through the ball. A lot of times you'll see a receiver stop his stride. He ran right through that ball.
You know, we were watching tapes and we said, well, I don't know how fast Danielson is.
Boy, he
so I do a little
there.
Research. He's a 100-meter champion in high school.
Yeah, no, that he had a lot of speed to get under that ball.
Excellent all-purpose guy. First down for the Cyclones. Not much. Whole host of guys all around Hiawatha Rutland.
I like how you popped yourself that you were doing your homework this week.
Pulled a muscle in my shoulder, patting myself on the back.
Iowa State, that's the one thing that Dan McCarney and Mack Brown both talk about, how much different the team speed is for the Cyclones than it was 8 years ago when McCarney first got here. And Mack Brown said it's 100% better than when Dan first got to Iowa State, and that's how they recruit.
Second down and 12. Rutland. Absolutely nothing. Coming up next Saturday, we've got either number 2 Oklahoma against number 20 Colorado, or these Longhorns will take on Nebraska. Plus other regional action next Saturday at 3:30 Eastern, right here on ABC Sports Championship Television. We'll be down in Raleigh, North Carolina. Ed, myself,
timeout
and Sam.
Iowa State. First charge timeout of the half.
How about NC State? 9-0.
T.A. McClendon, we all got to see him the other night. He's up there with Maurice Claret as one of the best freshman running backs in the entire country.
Look forward to seeing him. Meanwhile, here it's still 7-0, but the Cyclones are charging. BC Sports presentation of college football is brought to you by Chrysler. Drive equals love. By Circuit City. We know how you feel. That's why we're here. Circuit City, we're with you. By Aflac. Ask about it at work. And by Dell. Flexible enterprise solutions that are easy to buy, easy to own, easy as Dell. University of Texas Longhorn Band playing today, having the fans excited, even sitting in the rain. This is a terrific crowd. Die hard fans.
Well, Iowa State's already in field goal range here. They need to get some kind of route, 14 to 15 yards, to get this first down, or even take a shot in the end zone. They don't need to worry about it picking up yardage for the field goal.
They need 12. Wallace just throws it away.
and a smart play by Seneca Wallace. Did not want to take a sack. If he takes a sack there and loses 5 to 6 yards, I think that they would be out of the range of Adam Beneke.
Well, again, it was Kalen Thornton who was applying the pressure. He really played well against Oklahoma. 10 tackles, a sack, and a tackle for loss, and forced Wallace to throw that one away.
And this is about Beneke's max.
40-yard field goal.
Yards.
He's 0 for 2, 40-plus.
This will be a new career long if he can nail this one.
Plenty of distance. And it's good. So a 40-yard field goal by Adam Beneke. And Dan McCarney's Iowa State Cyclones are finally on the board. Texas 7, Iowa State 3. We'll be back. Rain has finally stopped a little bit. Bevo likes that. You tell him. 7-3 our score. Texas leading, 6:09 to play in the first half. Love Bevo.
I like the Kleenex he uses. It's his tongue.
Bevo was having a tough time with that yesterday. They said they've got him on antibiotics.
Oh, that's disgusting.
What are you talking about? Must be a
Kleenex
city.
Would go out of business if we could do that.
Must be a city slicker. Yelks kickoff goes 6-7 yards deep, and that's where it'll be down. So Texas will bring it out to the 20. Let's go downstairs. Here's Sam.
And Tim, it was Adam Beneke who put the Cyclones on the board. The walk-on place kicker. He's been giving the Cyclones kicking game some consistency of late, but it's been a long journey for Adam. He tried to make Colorado State team in 99. They didn't keep walk-on kickers. After one semester, he went to Arizona State. Didn't play football. Then it was off to Minnesota's Rochester Community Technical College in 2000. His team did go 12-0 there. He had a long of 50 yards there. And in 2001, ISU as a walk-on. 4 schools in 3 years for Adam Beneke.
Wow. Whatever it takes to get to where you're going, I guess. Roads to success go a lot of different ways. Pick up a 5. It'll be second down for Cedric Benson and the Longhorns. Hey, earlier we asked you the Aflac question. In what year was Texas awarded its last national championship? Hold it, boys. Don't put it up. My partner's got a guess.
75 or something, but you got to give a better clue. You know the answer.
I do know the answer.
Ah, 70.
Go, go!
280!
280!
Second down and 5 for Texas. Over the timing pattern of Williams, just knocked away at the last second, and now they throw a flag. It was knocked away by Ellis Hobbs, but they call him for pass interference.
Now this had to be earlier in the route.
Pass interference on the defense, 15 yards from the previous spot, first down.
Because Ellis Hobbs, all 5'7" of him, going against 6'4" Roy Williams. Good technique right in his hip pocket. Get that left arm down there a little bit. See, you know, Tim, listen, the offensive guy has his hand extended. The defensive guy has his hand extended. To me, that is not defensive pass interference. And John Scadaney had to be happy with the way that's the way you teach it. That's the way you tell this guy to play it every day in practice.
Watch the left hand. That's what they're watching with the flags. Here's Benson. Let's go back to Manhattan, Times Square Studio. John Saunders.
Very difficult. Kentucky so much better this year, but all the injuries for Georgia with Musa Smith out and John Stinchcomb, the fine tackle. I knew that was going to be a difficult game.
Sims times it again to Williams. Is he inbounds? No. Just out of bounds. Again, it was Williams and Hobbs bumping and grinding down the sideline. Williams 6'4", 210, going after the 5'7" Hobbs, looking for the mismatch. That's one of their mismatch guys you talked about earlier. 6'4" versus 5'7".
It's one of the things, I mean, Texas is always going to have a height advantage because of their size. But it's a little ridiculous against Iowa State. 5'7" is the average in the secondary for Texas. 6'2", that's a lot of vertical to give up.
Chris, in the first quarter was 3 for 3. Second quarter, he has yet to make a completion. 0 for 3, and he sacked this time back at the 35. Tim Tebrink with his second sack of the year. And boy, does that help the Cyclones.
John Sclodaney, who's been at Iowa State for 7 years and just been grinding along, grinding along. They used to be ranked in the hundreds in defense here at Iowa State, and they're slowly creeping into the top 25 every year.
Folks, they're punting to one of the most dangerous guys in the country, Todd Miller. He's already returned two this year. This is a kick very short. They don't want Miller to handle it. It goes out of bounds at the 35. So just by his presence, a 29-yard punt, the Cyclones will have great field position. So he does his job without even touching the football. Momentum has switched a little bit with the sack and a poor punt, 29-yarder. Dan McCarney's Cyclones now have some momentum. They scored the field goal to creep within 7-3 and have the ball again.
Seneca Wallace, 9 of 15 for 109 yards. Other than that interception, got some confidence back. Only had 4 completions last week against Oklahoma. Good to see he's playing well.
Throws to the outside. That ball was thrown on a dart. What a catch! Oh, Jamal Montgomery with a spectacular catch. Looked like Lynn Swan. Oh, my. A gain of 28 yards.
We'll take a look at our Chrysler passing playbook on that one. I think it's only fitting that we look at this great play right up top. Ball slightly underthrown by Seneca Wallace. A lot of times you do this on purpose. And Montgomery, soft hands to tip it back to himself. What a spectacular play.
Great concentration. Wallace again rolls way out of the pocket and throws it away. Coming with a safety blitz from Cedric Griffin, number 8. He got right into Wallace's face. Wallace started out 4 for 9 in the first quarter. Here in the second quarter, he's 6 for 8.
And the one thing that Iowa State got away from a little bit against Oklahoma, and everything just kind of fell apart for Dan McCarney and his staff and the entire team. But, you know, against Nebraska, when they were so good offensively, they moved the pocket around for Seneca Wallace. I mean, he's a good pocket passer. Don't kid yourself. This guy can stand in there and throw it. But they moved the pocket. They didn't move against Nebraska. They didn't move it against Oklahoma. And here today, a nice little mix for Seneca Wallace.
Wallace ranked 2nd in the Big 12, 23rd nationally in passing efficiency. 2nd down and 10. Blitz is coming. This is Wagner. Wagner loses yardage. Corey Redding again got there first.
We'll take a look at the Pacific Life game summary of how we got to 7 for Texas and 3 for Iowa State. The first drive goes 80 yards. Cedric Benson had 61 of them. There was one very tough one for the touchdown. And then very rare for Benson. He fumbles. It's very wet out there. And then because of a penalty, Beneke misses a field goal that would have put Iowa State on the board. Come back and kicks a career-long 40-yarder to get us to 7-3.
Longhorn fans on their feet. 3rd down and 13 for Seneca Wallace and Iowa State. Wallace steps up with plenty of time and hits Whitmer. 1st down inside the 20. Gain of 23, and Seneca Wallace so poised in the pocket, hitting 60% of his passes.
Boy, you mentioned it, though. That time was sensational. Right at the snap, 1,001, 1,002, 1,003, 1,004, 1,005, 1,006 he throws. That is a great job by his offensive line, because there was nothing there early for Seneca Wallace.
Folks, as you watch Wallace, think of this. Comparisons to Charlie Ward and a touchdown pass to Jamal Montgomery. Correction, Lance Young. 16-yard touchdown strike, Wallace to Young.
Boy, that's just a great throw again, Tim.
Wallace is on fire.
Yes, he is. A horrible game last week against Oklahoma. He's getting some help. Look at right up top and watch where he puts this ball. He knows with Babers back turned, keep it to the outside and the outside shoulder of his receiver. And boy, that's a nice job going up and making a play.
Another nice grab.
Yeah, it really was.
Extra point attempt is good. So Beneke splits the sticks, and Iowa State takes the lead with 2:10 to play in the first half.
And Tim, you just have to feel so good about Seneca Wallace and what he went through last week against Oklahoma. Dan McCarney said he had probably the best week of practice he's ever had since he's been at Iowa State this week coming back. He's such a competitor. But he had such a tough week against Oklahoma. Four completions. He was just totally off his game.
Well, there are the numbers from last week that you talk about. But while you look at those, let me tell you that he was 10 for 12 on third down conversions against Florida State. And after the game, Bobby Bowden compared him to Charlie Ward and Michael Vick.
Yeah, those are two pretty good names. And it's amazing when you're talking to Dan McCarney about Seneca Wallace and where he came from. He went to Oregon State. He was playing defensive back. He went to Sacramento City College, played quarterback there, and only two Division I-A schools, Dan McCarney at Iowa State and New Mexico State, wanted him as a quarterback coming out of JUCO.
This will take Basher 9 yards deep. He'll down it there. They'll bring it out to the 20. So another touchback. And there are the numbers for today on Seneca Wallace.
And we were talking at the open of the game about him trying to get back into the Heisman race, and with the way that this schedule lines up for them, on the road last week against Oklahoma, today against Texas, they have to go to Kansas State and Colorado. If he keeps making plays like this on the road against quality opponents, I think he can fight and scratch his way back into the race.
A couple of great catches, but he's 8 for 10, 128 yards in this quarter with that touchdown.
It's twice as many completions as he had in the entire game against Oklahoma.
So now let's see what Sims can do with the 2-minute drill. Throws a strike to Thomas, and Thomas is at the 25-yard line. Brandon Brown makes the tackle. First catch for Thomas today. It'll bring up second and four.
Well, you can just see Sloan Thomas, the way he's walking, he's not 100% healthy.
Hurry up for Texas. 1:39 to play in the half. Sims rolls, throws. Thomas out of bounds, no catch. That'll stop the clock at 1:33. Folks, want you to go to the internet. We've got a question for you. Here's our poll. Want you to weigh in on, should college football have instant replay? ESPN.com, keyword ABC Sports. Weigh in on it. Let us know what you think.
Got to get something here. I think you can take a shot across the middle of the field. Something easy. You have to get this first down. You don't want to punt it away the way Iowa State's been playing on offense.
Three-step drop throw to the outside. Throws a strike. That's complete. And it should be enough for the first down. So Hanahan has the catch. He goes out of bounds at the 37-yard line. Pickup of eight. His first catch of the day.
And that was a good read by Chris Sims. Got a good look at what kind of defense Iowa State was running. They were playing a little bit of off zone, and he knew on the out cut he was going to have Shanahan. Skladany just happy. He doesn't want these big time receivers from Texas running free right now. Make Texas earn every inch of the field.
Quick out, throws a strike. This is Johnson, and Johnson spins his way across the 40. There's a flag down.
Did you hear the Iowa State defender right before the snap yell and watch the draw? It's tough to run a draw without a back in the backfield.
This is against Texas for holding. Coming up on the Capital One
holding,
halftime
holding
show.
On the offense, 10 yards from the spot of the foul. Repeat first down.
John Saunders and Terry Bowden will have highlights and analysis from all of today's big games, including Notre Dame and Florida State. That game was surprising, but I'm a believer now.
I wasn't before. And they do it with turnovers. I mean, how many times could Chris Ricks give the ball over to Notre Dame? But you have to think it's part of the coaching with Tyrone Willingham and Kent Bear's defensive coordinator doing a sensational job.
Sims has the completion. Shanahan again across the 40 to the 42.
Got to go. You don't want to have to burn a timeout right now. You got to go. Get him up there and get him set.
Clock stops with 56 seconds. Now they set it. They put it in play.
Pick up the first down.
Oh, boy. Timeout, Texas.
They wasted about 12 seconds trying to figure out what to do. If you couldn't get up and get set and run a play for the first down, you should have burned that timeout. And Mac Brown saying right now, he's over there talking to Chris Sims, they should have gotten that timeout a lot sooner.
Mac's one of those heady coaches, too. He wants his players to think. He doesn't want mental mistakes.
Well, I think Mac Brown does a good job of keeping himself a little bit away from the fray. You know, he was an offensive coordinator for a long time. He actually spent 2 years as the offensive coordinator at Iowa State back in the early 80s at Oklahoma.
Donnie Duncan's staff.
Yeah, he ran some great offenses at while he was at Oklahoma. But as a head coach, he separated himself so that he can watch the entire game and manage the whole game. And I think some head coaches get a little caught up in wanting to be involved in every play call and everything that happens. And it's kind of hard to step back and say, all right, what do we have to do? When can we use a timeout? Clock management and field position management.
Mac Brown is the Big 12's active winningest coach. He's come into Texas and done a marvelous job here.
And everybody knows that it begins and ends with recruiting for Mac Brown, year in and year out. And this year, you know, the class they had with Chris Sims and Corey Redding, they said was one of the best ever at Texas. A lot of people around here saying the class that just came in, some of these young guys that we've already seen, Selvin Young, the running back, defensive lineman that's in there playing for him right now, Roderick Wright, they think this class that came in this year is better than that one.
Wow. Well, they've got 16 home wins in a row. But, I mean, they're in some kind of battle here this afternoon with Iowa State.
Nothing crazy here. You just got to pick up the first down, get up to the line of scrimmage when the clock stops to move the chains, so get ready for your next play.
Second down and one. Quarterback sneak first. Clock stops with 47 seconds left.
Greg Davis, the offensive coordinator, has been taking some heat for being a little conservative, but that's the right call. All you have to do, pick up the first down now. Have the second play called. They didn't have to recall it. Get ready to go.
Sims chased out. He's sacked at the 39-yard line.
Timeout. Get yourself a timeout. You got to get it.
The timeout is called with 33 seconds left,
timeout,
but Tyson Smith with the sack.
Now, Tyson Smith was a guy that they were very concerned about because of his speed. He's not a big guy. He goes about 235 pounds. And Texas knew they were going to have their hands full with this guy coming off the edge.
Coming up tomorrow, ABC Sports has a great day of golf. The tees off with the final round coverage of the Buick Challenge at 3 Eastern. Then at 5 Eastern, join Mike Tirico for an inside look at Tiger Woods and the PGA Tour's top 30 money winners as they prepare for the PGA Tour's end of the season classic. Road to the Tour Championship, presented by Coca-Cola, tomorrow right here on ABC.
Well, and they had to burn there. Last time out there did Texas because of they had four vertical receivers, and when Sims got sacked, they were 30 yards down the field. There's no way they could have got back. Clock may have run out on them.
33 seconds remain in the first half. It'll be second and 18.
You look what that Iowa State defense has done today with the sacks and the forced fumbles. That first drive, it looked like they were going to get drug up and down this field by Cedric Benson and this offensive line. They've really buckled down.
A drug problem. Second and 18 for Texas. The out pattern. Williams drops it. Correction, that's Thomas.
Well, and now things can get interesting for Iowa State with two timeouts. With third and just a little over a country mile to go for Texas. Back everybody up. Take your secondary. Squat them in there at about 14 yards. And I would really want, if I'm Iowa State, to make Texas punt this ball away.
See the numbers on Sims. Boy, he struggled a little bit here in the second quarter. Now seems to have plenty of time. Rolls to the left, throws underneath. Not nearly enough for the first. Gets back to the line of scrimmage, and the Boo Birds come out.
Well, and that was a bad play. Listen, the pressure caused that. They're booing because they don't think the right play was called. They need to settle down. It was just great pressure by Iowa State up front. Sims did what he did. But going out of bounds was a big mistake because now Iowa State's going to get this ball back with 14 seconds or so left, and they're going to have two timeouts left.
Brian Bradford, who averages 42 yards a punt. And he's punting again to Todd Miller, who is some kind of dangerous. They try to punt away from him again.
Oh boy.
And it's another short kick. Well, they don't want the ball in Miller's hands. Mm-mm. And he is really causing some problems even without the football now. He had a 29-yarder. This kick is 26.
Well, with a 10-7 lead, Dan McCarney may be okay just going to the... You know, they're going to come out in their safe formation and take a knee, but... Two timeouts, 13 seconds. I guess it's the right play. You don't want to get too crazy and have a turnover here.
Clock play by Seneca Wallace, and the final 10 ticks will go off the clock. Terrific first half at Darrell K. Royal, Texas Memorial Stadium. First half comes to an end. 10-7, Iowa State. Now let's join John Saunders and Terry Bowden at Times Square Stadium in New York City.
Through the hands of Roy Williams, so it's tough to blame him on that pick.
Tony Yelk kicks off, and they'll down it and bring it out. Vasher downs it 5 yards deep to put it at the 20. Let's go downstairs. Here's Sam.
And Tim, I spoke with Coach McCarney moments ago. He said the key is that they're making big plays. They just have to keep the intensity up in the second half. He said it's a shame they took points off the board with that penalty, but a lot of credit to their offense, their offensive line, and to Seneca Wallace. He said he's come back and he's played with a lot of confidence in this game. Guys.
Dan McCarney's done an outstanding job. This was a program which won only 27 games during the 1990s. He's come in. And just since 2000, he's gone 22-10. Here's the first play. This is Benson starting like he began the game with a big hole and a nice pickup.
Take a look at the Pacific Life game summary. The first half stats. The turnovers, Iowa State. Seneca Wallace had an interception early. A fumble by Cedric Benson. Interception by Sims kept Iowa State going, and 217 yards of total offense for Iowa State in the first half against a defense that's giving up only 255 yards a game, fifth in the country of Texas.
Benson again, and that fumble Benson that you mentioned of Benson in the first half, only his fourth in more than 400 carries. Protects the ball very well. Very unusual that he would put it on the ground, but it was a pretty good lick. It'll bring up third down and four.
Iowa State comes out here on defense to begin the second half, and basically exactly where they were at the end of the first half. We already talked about the athleticism of this defensive front for Iowa State.
And its experience.
Yeah, and then they're doing a really nice job of the holes closing very quickly.
These guys run to the football. Third down, they need four. Three-step drop, the quick pass to Williams. Enough for the first down. Tiptoes along the line to just about the 35. Roy Williams had that ankle surgery to move bone spurs. He's been fighting a sore hamstring, but certainly one of the quality receivers in this nation.
He's missed a lot of practice time with that hamstring, missed the Tulane game, and it's really thrown off the timing between him and Chris. They're just starting to get it back.
First down, Sims, the pitch to Benson. Gets a block on the corner, but a terrific play out on the corner by Jeremy Lloyd.
Boy, that was a nice play by Lloyd. Fought off the block by the fullback. Dip back inside. Be on the top part of your screen. Right there, he's actually working against the receiver out there, B.J. Johnson. A little bit of a mismatch, a linebacker with a receiver trying to block him, but that's a good job staying alive and making the play.
So it'll be second down and eight.
112. 112.
Benson to the 40.
Guy who was Cedric Benson bursting onto the scene midway through the year last year. A guy that has really had to kind of change his outlook a little bit is Ivan Williams. He's coming off the field right now, fullback. But when Benson came in, Williams was the starter, and Cedric Benson having himself a very nice afternoon, and everybody here in Texas knew they had something special. Just took them a little while to get him going last year.
Texas needs five on third down. Sims, this time with time, throws a dart, and it's complete to B.J. Johnson. Kingfish should have enough for the first, his third catch of the day. Brandon Willis Johnson, in the first grade, as you take a look at him, his class had several Brandons. So he said, well, just call me B.J., and it's stuck in the first grade and ever since. Quality receiver.
At least you can remember B.J. Brandon's just one of those names that B.J.'s always, it might as well go by a nickname. It's easier to remember.
Looks like Derek Dockery jumped. So Texas moves back.
While the ball was dead, false start on the offense. 5 yards, remains first down.
Folks, there's a 3-year starter, outstanding tackle who moved down to guard, 6'6", 345-pound senior. That's a mental mistake.
He carries that weight so well. I spent time talking to him yesterday. I've lost 80 pounds since I played. He's like, well, you got to tell me how to lose weight. I said, we got to cut the starch out. I said, well, I'm not going to lose the weight then. I can't get rid of the starch in my diet.
I want to see your fat pictures. I can't believe you were a 300-pounder. Benson with a terrific run, breaks loose. Benson inside the 30, foot race. 10, 5, Benson dives for the touchdown. Texas on the board again. Boy, did Texas need that from Cedric Benson. Extra point, high snap, but the kick is good. Folks, he was an idol before he got to Austin. He was the Texas High School Player of the Year. Now he's the Doak Walker Award candidate. And this will get him some votes. Texas now leads. A 59-yard run by Cedric Benson has electrified this crowd. 7 plays, 80 yards, 59 of those on the touchdown run. Almost 3.5 minutes on that drive. Spectacular. By Cedric Benson.
Longest run before that was 39 yards. You got to go all the way back to UNC. He hadn't had a run over 16 yards in the last 5 ball games.
McGee's kickoff will be taken by Young at the 5. Young to the 20. And is stopped and downed at the 24-yard line.
All right, now we got to give some love to Dockery. We were talking to him yesterday. Watch this drive block on Jordan Karstens and the cutback right now. Mark Timmons nearly breaks his ankle with 650 pounds of Karstens and Dockery landing on him. But when you look at it up tight, this is just a dominant, dominant block by Derek Dockery. Look, gets his hands inside.
Perfect form tackle.
Yeah. Oh, come on. Such a defensive guy.
Look at his right arm.
Now his hands are inside. His pad level is perfect. That's nice pad level for a guy who stands 6'6".
That arm was in the middle of his two numbers in the back. You linemen love to stick together. Here's Seneca Wallace, dumps it to Wagner. Wagner about a yard short of a first down. He's big. When he gets you, he blocks you, he's tough. Let's go back to New York. Here's John Saunders. John Mills to be throwing picks. Here's Seneca Wallace on the loose. First down. He'll go out of bounds at the 43-yard line. 44 they mark it. So they'll move the chains. And Iowa State moving up dangerously close once again to midfield. Gain of 11.
Well, on the defensive end to Seneca's right as he fakes a handoff, just didn't stay home. He bit on the fake and get. You just don't want this guy to get into the open field right now. There's a defensive end right there. See him dive down inside to take that play fake. Remember yesterday we were talking to those guys about staying home in their assignments. That's a blown assignment.
Danielson in motion. Wagner straight ahead. Looking for some room, can't find it. Reed Boyd stopped up the middle, made the tackle, and just barely Wagner got back to the line of scrimmage.
Reed Boyd, a guy that they used so many different ways in this package. You know, they were trying to find ways. When Kalen Thornton was out, they had to find ways to get pressure, and one of the ways was with Reed Boyd up around the line of scrimmage, standing there, stunning with the defensive line. Now, with Kalen Thornton back, able to get a little more pressure with the front four, he can play more of a true linebacker spot.
Second down and 10. Texas shows blitz. Wallace unloads quickly and underthrows. Intended for Montgomery. Next Saturday, we got either number 2 Oklahoma against number 20 Colorado, where these Longhorns will take on Nebraska. Other regional action next Saturday at 3:30 Eastern, right here on ABC. Ed Dial will be in Raleigh, North Carolina, to see the unbeaten NC State Wolfpack.
Boy, and big Marcus Tubbs in there waving his arms, looking like a cheerleader. 305-pound cheerleader.
Third down and 10. Pressure. Sacked. Derek Johnson with his third sack of the year.
Well, and it's a blitz again from the outside. Again, you're bringing smaller bodies in to try to hem in Seneca Wallace. He's got to step up into the pocket. And the freshman, Roderick Wright, gets a freebie, but it was the blitz on the outside that made that happen.
This is Nathan Basher. So they'll start at the 22, a 45-yard punt, a 3-yard return. 9:47 to play in the third. Texas 14, Iowa State 10. Horn and a little Longhorn. Enjoying the day at Darrell K. Royal Texas Memorial Stadium. Spectacular campus, great town, Austin.
Great facilities here at Texas. Mack Brown left his mark at UNC. Now making his mark here. And one of the really impressive things, Sam did that report earlier on this field, is, I mean, it's been pouring rain here for 3 days. This is as light as it's been since we've been here. And this field is just in perfect shape.
Tell you this, Mack Brown was leaving his mark on the officials during that timeout. He was tattooing one of them. Wanted an explanation, and I think you were right. I think it was the halo rule. He thought it was violated.
I think Reed Boyd did a really nice job getting down. Nathan Basher, so dangerous punt returner last year, had a couple of touchdowns. But that ankle is still just not 100% for Basher.
What do you think this is? First, Mack Brown had their attention, was talking to the referee. Now they have the Iowa State coaches on the sideline, and they're talking to them. See if we can get an explanation. No, they'll just put it back in play. Mm-hmm. All right. Well, John Bible be that way. He's our referee today. We'll find out eventually. First down and 10. Here's Cedric Benson again. First down, almost broke it. Gain of 12.
And Tillman Holloway does such a nice job. Watch the left guard when he pulls. Gets a little seal block right there. Look at him driving his feet. Makes a big pile of bodies. And he's got a double read in that. He either kicks a guy out if he gets upfield, or he wrap blocks. And that time he wrap blocks, and Benson bounces it to the outside.
Benson with 165 yards and 2 touchdowns already. Now they drag the tight end. And a big pickup by Ivan Williams. Williams all the way out across midfield to the 47.
And Williams was a starting running back last year. until Cedric Benson was ready to go. Comes out in a little fullback flat. Good job of catching the ball with his hands and getting upfield. And Williams has done such a spectacular job of adjusting his game from the featured running back to a blocking back. He's getting a lot of time today with Matt Trissel, the starting fullback, a little banged up. He's doing a nice job blocking in there. A little check down by Chris Sims.
Here's the pitch back, ball's loose. And again, Cedric Benson had a tough time with the handle. Came into this game with only 3 fumbles and 398 carries, now well over 400. He's lost 1 fumble and put this one on the ground.
A lot of times, well, he lets that get way too close into his body. Coaches always say, get the ball, get your hands between the ball and your pads. That hard plastic, if it gets there, you never know what kind of bounce it's going to take.
Williams comes out of the game. Now they send him back in, and Thomas goes
in. They might have to take a timeout. They weren't sure which personnel they wanted on the field. Now Ivan Williams comes in late.
Play clock down to 4. Get it off at 1. And it's intended for Williams. He has the completion and picks up a yard. So Williams runs off the field, comes back on the field, then runs the route and picks up a yard.
When Sims is screaming at the sideline for their indecision about what personnel to send into the game. We met with him yesterday. He was talking about he gets emotional sometimes. And Mac Brown was saying how much more vocal he's become this year with Major Applewhite gone. It was kind of that big brother syndrome. And he gets into it a lot. He says, I try to stay calm, but sometimes I get a little fired up when things aren't going right. And he was not happy how long it took to get the play in.
Third down and 9. Plenty of time. Now chased out of the pocket. Now in trouble, and he's sacked. Jeremy Lloyd with the sack. That's a coverage sack.
Chris Sims needs to realize right here that Seneca Wallace, he is not. Just throw it away. Do something. Don't cut back. Don't cut back. Throw it away. Lose a couple more yards. I mean, there was just nothing there. They were going to have to punt anyway, but don't get a little dangerous running around with that ball.
Trying to keep it away from Miller. Miller has a chance at this one. But they're all over him. So for the first time this afternoon, they punt to Miller. It's only a 31-yarder. But Texas was all over it. 6:49 to play in the third. Texas still by 4. But here come the Cyclones. 6:49 to play, third period. Texas has regained the lead over Iowa State, 14-10. And now Seneca Wallace in the offense for the Cyclones of Iowa State will go to work. Good pressure by the Texas defense in the last series. Wallace had very little room to work.
Iowa State needs to go back to what was working there the latter part of the second half, all of the second quarter. Let this guy move around a little bit. He can throw it so well on the move.
This is Danielson with the throwback to Wallace. Texas is all over it. A pickup of 1 yard. Cedric Griffin, the nickelback, was all over him.
Well, and this play just took way too long to develop for Iowa State. If you're going to do something like this, you have to take advantage of the misdirection. As it's coming back and he makes the handoff, slows down too soon. That was not a good enough fake by Lane Danielson. He's got to carry out the fake just for another step longer. But you better believe that Texas was working all week on knowing where Seneca Wallace was, even when he didn't have the ball in his hands.
Second down and 9. Wagner around the corner to the 30. Out to the 36-yard line. So it's a first down, a pickup of 17 yards. Michael Wagner quietly having a nice game.
In the left side of the offensive line for Iowa State, just like we saw Derek Dockery a minute ago on Cedric Benson's run, just doing a really nice job of maintaining their blocks. When you run a lot of zone plays, where it's just zone blocking, it's not man-to-man, you've got the left gap, I've got the gap outside of that, a guy like Michael Wagner, all he needs you to do is stay on your man. You don't have to kill him. Just make sure that he doesn't come off early enough for me to make a cut.
Wagner goes out. Hiawatha Rutland now is the setback. And I mean, he's deep. Incomplete. It was intended for Montgomery. And on the quick seam, he was open.
Yeah, that's one that Seneca Wallace would want back.
Looked like he rushed it.
Yeah, it did. He looked a little herky-jerky in his drop. I think that's a new dance step here in Austin.
I saw you doing the two-step last night.
It looked a little herky-jerky, though.
Second down and 10.
Don't laugh. That's not even funny.
It was funny last night.
Yes, it was.
The reverse to Danielson, and again Texas all over it. They'll lose 2 yards. Rod Babers came up fast. Hey folks, let's take a look at our Tostitos BCS standings. Everybody knows by now Oklahoma jumped Miami in the BCS poll. Notre Dame with a huge win today. Virginia Tech, boy, does that set up that Miami-Virginia Tech game for December 7th so well.
And I would guess Monday night when they release this again that Notre Dame may jump ahead of Miami in the BCS standings, and I'm not sure they shouldn't with their strength of schedule.
NC State 11th, now 9-0. They'll jump up as well. Seneca Wallace in a whole lot of trouble. Avoids two Texas defenders and now throws a tough pass, and it should have been caught. Lance Young had his hands on it, and that was some play by Wallace that Young couldn't finish.
Boy, this looked like it was going to be a 20-yard loss by Seneca Wallace. And just at the very last second, blitz comes from the outside. That's Derek Johnson trying to run him down, and Dakari Pearson. He picks those feet up, and that's a great play. You always say, hey, don't throw back across your body, but there was no middle safety there for Texas. That ball should have been caught by Young.
It would have been a tough catch, but what a marvelous play that would have wound up to be.
And Young had enough for the first down.
Wallace is Flutie-esque. Looks like Doug Flutie a little bit. Nathan Vasher takes it at the 21. And Vasher out to the 39-yard line. Punt of 43 yards and a return of 18. So very quiet here at Memorial Stadium right now. 44-32 to play. Texas still by 4. This would have been some catch by Young. The big guy looks pretty comfortable right now. 14-10 Texas. Bevo watching. But the stadium really has gotten quiet here recently. Seems to be a little lull.
Yeah, a little lull in the action.
Echoed through the body language of Bevo. Best starting field position for Texas today. Longhorns trailed at the half, now up by 4. Young and Williams out of the eye behind Sims. Play action. And Sims is again hit behind the line of scrimmage, and this will be a sack by Chris Whitaker. Let's go down to Sam.
Well, guys, you thought Cedric Benson was the most popular guy here today. Think again. It's this guy, Bevo. Now, this is the 15th year for this particular Bevo. There's been some talk of retirement, which could be in the near future. He says no. He's about 65 in human years. He's 18 years old. What is a typical workday like for Bevo? Well, his handlers make sure he's up by 8, gets his hair brushed at 8:30. Then it's on to the truck. He gets some breakfast, arrives at the stadium at 11, where he lays around until game time. Tough job. I got a little note about Bevo as well. A former Bevo was stolen in 1963 by students at A&M. They eventually confessed to a Texas Ranger who told them, hey, that's cattle rustling. That's punishable by hanging in the state of Texas. They were off the hook, though. Guys.
Sam, I noticed you're not getting too close to Bevo.
Would you?
Yeah, Ed and I were out with him yesterday.
I guess you could say he's a bully.
It's the best date you've had in a while, Tim.
Don't steer us wrong here. Oh, boy, Janet. Janet will get you to that. Third down and long for Sims. This ball incomplete. Wow. Hit Thomas right in the face mask.
Boy, that was a really poor set of downs for Texas. Barely got anything on first down. On second down, everybody was covered. I believe it's Robert Timmons who just never even saw this ball coming, and Sims takes a shot right under the chin by Jordan Karstens.
Miller back for Iowa State.
And wasting, they wasted this great field position.
Blocked. And Iowa State has it. Iowa State gets on and off the field so quickly, and their special teams cause all kinds of havoc. But Nick Moser came through, got the block, and now Iowa State is in business inside the 30.
And it's Nick Moser. It's Nick Moser coming right up the middle, and this is just bad assignment by Texas. That guy's got to be blocked. Oh, the center slid the wrong way. Can you believe it? He didn't get the right call. He should have slid to his left as the up back came to his right, and he tried to get back there at the last moment. That was a bad blocking assignment by Texas.
Seneca Wallace now inside the 30. And for Iowa State, it's like running downhill when you give him great field position. Here's the pitch to Rutland. Inside the 25, down near the 20.
Well, in that time, Iowa State caught Texas in man coverage on that side, and they ran the option to that side. When Rutland got that ball, there was nobody. Watch Vasher right here. He's in man, so he has to go with the receiver running downfield. There's nobody on the pitch man.
A lot of times the center calls the blocking schemes.
Yeah, well, the up back in the punt protection came to his right. He needed to go to his left, and that's that great field position. Not only did not do anything with it, a big play in special teams to kill you down here.
Second down and two, incomplete. Right now, Wallace is out of rhythm. We're going to get back in rhythm and take you all the way back to the skyscrapers of Manhattan. Here's John Saunders. And you wonder how much his not being in Florida State has hurt that program. Michael Wagner now the setback. Three straight incompletions for Wallace. Folks, this is going to be close to the first. I do not think they got it.
No.
It's going to bring up fourth down and short. Thornton tripped him up. Good play defensively.
Dan McCarty deciding what he's going to do on fourth and short. It looks like he may go for it. Tim, I think in a game that's going back and forth and his defense playing the way it is, I think you got to take the points.
Folks, these two teams could be playing for the at-large berth in the BCS. They both still believe they're alive in the Big 12 Conference Championship. Any way you look at it, today's game is huge. And Dan McCarty says, because of the size of this game, I'm going for it on fourth. He needs two. Wagner has the first.
In hindsight, obviously, it was the right call. But I just think at this point in the game, you might kick that field goal, take a little of the momentum back. But this the exact same play that they just ran for a loss, and this time the left side of that offensive line, Casey Shelton, Bob Montgomery, and the center, Zach Butler, come through for Dan McCarty to get the first.
Well, they get a lot of momentum with the first down. They move the chains, and now Wallace inside the 20. Wagner the setback. Option. All the way down the line, and they lose a yard. Reed Boyd with a terrific defensive play. Texas strung it out the distance.
This time, as opposed to the last time they ran the option to the left, they strung it out. Texas did such a nice job, and Reed Boyd's been so active in the middle today for Texas. Did such a nice job coming inside out from that Mike linebacker spot. Wallace had nothing to do with it. That option down here just has not been working for Iowa State in the red zone. The trips to the left, I would not be surprised if you get some kind of roll to that side by Seneca Wallace.
Wallace comes back the other way. Still picks up about 5 yards. Thornton had the pressure. Wallace goes out of bounds.
Well, you know, you want to keep the option, especially with a guy like Wallace. in your package, but they just have done nothing. And you go, I mean, you go all the way back to the Florida State game, a game that if they'd have played well in the first quarter, they probably would have won. But on fourth and one, they run the option with Wallace and he gets nothing. I know you want it in there, but to me, down in the red zone, it hasn't worked for them all year. They got to start rethinking calling that play so much in here.
Third down and six for Wallace. More than 83,000 fans here today, and they make their presence known. Wallace buys some time and throws it away out of the end zone. So that'll set up the field goal. So all for naught. This is not what Dan McCarney wanted after the blocked field goal. Thought he had a great opportunity to take a 17-14 lead. Yeah, he'll try to settle for three.
But running two options in a row on first and second down and then being so stuck with what you can do on third and six. I think they could have done more with the talents of Wallace.
Adam Benneke, this will be a 32-yard field goal. He's 6 for 7 from this distance. It's long enough, but wide right.
Well, and neither team taking advantage. Texas had that great field position after Nathan Vasher had a nice punt return. They go three and out. Iowa State blocks the punt and gets nothing out of it.
Wow.
And this just a straight push. Missed one earlier after a penalty. Made one down inside the 4-yard line. Illegal formation backed him up. He missed one. So 1 for 3 on the day in a game that's going back and forth. Those points are humongous.
Benneke came in 11 for 14 but struggling today. First down Texas. Play clock down to 4. Benson. Not much.
Benson on the carry.
Well, you watch. Watch Jordan Carstens. He is such a player. Big old number 92. Big time leader. He's having a huge, huge year. Former walk-on.
He's a guy came in, was 228 pounds. NCAA rules, you're allowed 105 players coming into 2-a-days. He was the 105th that came to camp. He's beefed himself up to 300 pounds. And Dan McCarney says he is the best leader on a team that I've ever been around.
Says he works all week. He's the hardest worker we have. Then he goes home on Sundays and works on the farm for his daddy. Cedric Benson has a hold to the 27-yard line. Not enough for the first. It'll bring up third down and a long 3. Nick Leaders with the tackle, tripped him up. Gets a good mark out of it.
They're just going to let that clock run out, get themselves to the fourth quarter. But both of these offenses stuck in the mud, and there's no mud on this field. They just haven't been helping themselves with little tiny mistakes.
Well, Texas will have third down and 2 when we start the final 15. The Longhorns lead by 4. Our presentation of college football will continue after this message and a word from our local stations. You are watching ABC Sports. His recruits here today, hook 'em horns. Texas leading 14-10 as we start the final 15. But a big third down and 2 situation for Sims and the offense.
Bang away with Benson.
He's got the first. A 19-year-old sophomore bangs his way in for the first down.
Well, in Texas with the 59-yard touchdown run, but both, I mean, if you took that out of the mix, both of these offenses went to sleep there in the third quarter.
Benson now with 175 yards, 2 touchdowns. And he gets so many of those yards, what I call yaks, yards after contact. Sims, deep drop, throws to Benson. Create some space for him, gets him out there to the 39-yard line, and Benson and the Longhorns are on the move again. 14-22 to play. Let's take you back to New York. John Sauner, 103 yards today for Benson, yards after contact.
Cedric Benson, makes no bones about who he models his game, his life, and everything behind is Ricky Williams. And it's really stunning coming into today's game, the first 19 games of these two great players' careers. It's almost eerie how close they are. The only thing that Cedric Benson in this graphic lags behind Ricky Williams in is dreadlocks.
I'll tell you this, though. I think Cedric Benson at this stage of his career, and he's only 19 years old, I think he is a stronger runner and does better after contact than Ricky did.
That's a bold statement, my friend.
Backside pressure throws has the completion. B.J. Johnson has his fourth catch. They move the chains, first down Texas, and now they start to eat away at the clock.
This is the type of drive, and the thing that Iowa State does not need, John Sladany, the defensive coordinator, talked all week about Chris Sims and his strengths and weaknesses. And if you allow him to set his feet, Sims will pick you apart. If you allow him to just lock in, get his feet set, get into his rhythm, he will absolutely rip you with that. He's got a great arm. He throws such a nice ball. You can't let him get into rhythm.
Here's Benson again, and just such a powerful runner. You say it's a bold statement or not, but at this stage of his career, he's already got more freshman yards than Ricky. That's not bold. That's fact.
I know. I was just teasing you.
This guy's special.
Oh, no, he is. He is. I mean, the first freshman in Texas history to ever run for 1,000 yards. And I mean, there's been a couple of guys that have worn the burnt orange that are pretty good. Ricky Williams, Earl Campbell, and guys who played a lot as freshmen.
Earl Campbell and Yaks, that's a different story.
It's a whole different story.
Second down. Texas needs 7. Benson again. Carrying tacklers, spinning and driving close to another first down marker. He'll be just shy. It'll bring up 3rd down and 1.
And again, Greg Davis, the offensive coordinator here at Texas and quarterback's coach, has been taking some heat about his conservative play calling. But right now, with the way Benson is going, you don't need to do anything else. Don't risk anything. You got 3rd and 1. Benson's your guy. Pound him away.
Right now, they're shortening the game.
Mm-hmm. Be as conservative as you want at this stage of the game.
Benson, left side, 1st down, and more. Ball's on the ground. Iowa State says they got it, but the official says not. Texas, 1st down.
When you talk about that Cedric Benson will be there someday, but his freshman year. You know, he didn't start till the 6th game of the season. He played very sparingly. And to end up with 1,000 yards and not really even play in the first 4 ball games, it was an amazing run at the end of the season.
Boy, he set a bucket full of freshman records. Play action. Sims throws. Close to another 1st down. They picked up 9.
Just a real simple play action. They've been pounding away with Cedric Benson. They get him off the field to give him a little rest. Bring in Selvin Young and Ivan Williams, the fullback, just comes out in that little fullback flat that we've seen a couple of times. A nice, easy pitch and catch. All set up because Cedric Benson has been able to pound the middle of this Iowa State defense. They have to respect the run now.
This is Selvin Young. Has the 1st down. Ellis Hobbs tripped him up, but the clock is now down to 10:27.
Boy, and you can see a little pep in Selvin Young's step, can't you, Tim?
Absolutely.
Benson has got great power inside, and he's got plenty of speed. We saw that on the 59-yard touchdown. But Selvin Young has that little shift. Over the next year or two, you start to think with Selvin Young and Cedric Benson to complement each other, it's going to be a pretty tough backfield.
Told you that Benson's 19 years old. Young is even younger. Play clock at 1. They get it off. Sims going to the corner. This is a floating duck. Almost intercepted.
And B.J. Johnson, Chris Sims, he got nailed right when he threw it, and he couldn't get what he wanted on it, but he needs to give B.J. Johnson a high five because that was a pick that B.J. Johnson just broke up.
That was Timmons, who almost had the pick.
Right as Sims let this go, he got a shot right to the ribs and it floated on him. But B.J. Johnson goes over the top of Timmons to knock this away. And Sims didn't get to see this while he was flat on his back. But tomorrow in films, I promise you, he's going to give B.J. a little tap on the side and thank him for this.
So it brings down second and 10. Quick out. This is Williams. Tap dances across the 25, down to the 23. Not enough for the first. It'll bring up third down and short.
Get Benson back in the game. He's rested enough. Jog him on. He's in there for the passing play, but this is his territory. They've been able to get 2 yards anytime they've wanted to on this drive.
Big old Will Matthews comes into the game now, a 6'3", 250-pound sophomore fullback, yep, along with Benson.
The other thing is, too, you don't want to lose any yardage here. You're already in field goal range to try to make this a 7-point game if you don't pick up the first.
Matthews leads, Benson follows, first down, Texas. Four straight third down conversions for the Longhorns.
The official's not...
Oh, wait a minute, look at this mark.
I still think he got it. He's right on it. Oh, it's going to be close. And I know this crowd's going to want Mac Brown to go for it if this is short. I'm not sure it is, but.
Guarantee you there aren't any kinks in that chain here in Texas. Just short.
Everybody in the world wants Mac Brown to go for it, and I think he will. But I'm not so sure you just don't kick the field goal and go up 7 points with Iowa State not doing so well in the second half so far offensively and your defense finally starting to step up and play. Now, if you're going to do it, though, it's the horse that brought you here. You should just put it in his hands.
Again, it's Big Matthews and Benson. Matthews will lead Sims. I don't know if he got it. Oh, now he gets a great mark.
Well, I think it was his initial charge. And Iowa State celebrating, but I think his initial charge by Sims got the ball across where he needed it, over that 21-yard line.
Well, I don't know. That, I don't think he made it, but he got a very good mark.
Well, one official ran out and signaled that it was a first down, and now the officials got together. You know, Tim, I wouldn't be surprised if they talked about the spot and somebody came in and overruled where the spot was.
Bring out the chain again. Everybody around. It's tough to get a view. Oh, my. Look at that.
As close as you can get.
I still think he got a terrific mark.
And what McCarney is arguing is that Sims had the ball close to his body. He never reached out.
He never admitted it.
Oh, boy.
He never
made it. You're right. You made the initial call, Tim. You're right. He never even got past the guard. That was a fantastic spot. And Dan McCarney has every right to be upset. You made the call, Tim. That was the right call. He didn't make that.
First down, Texas. Benson left side. Breaks a tackle, spins. Gets inside the 15 to the 11-yard line. Cedric Benson just eating up yardage now.
Well, I'm not going to doubt your old eagle eyes anymore. No, you were absolutely right. It looked to me like he may have gotten there. But, you know, McCarney, when he was talking to the official, was showing him, hey, he never reached the ball out to get any kind of yardage. And when he got hit, he wasn't even past the left guard, the movement of the left guard. And I think Dan McCarney was right that that was not a first down.
218 yards rushing now, and Benson has 199 of them. Here's Young inside the 10. Get 200 yards rushing, anybody will win.
The old cliche. Got to establish the run and stop the run. Well, Texas has, Iowa State has not.
Point being that Mac does get some 200-yard rushing games in there, and they never lose.
Yeah, a few of those with that guy, Ricky Williams.
Yep. And it looks like a lot more to come. Here's Young to the 5, to the 2-yard line. Selvin Young, they call him Stoney. 6 feet, 195, true freshman. Mack likes him because he takes the pressure off Cedric Benson.
You know who he reminds me of? We had a guy when I was with the Washington Huskies, 91. We had a true freshman by the name of Napoleon Kaufman, who went on to a great career in the NFL. He's one of those guys that everyone in the stands, every time he gets it, you hold your breath. I'm going to try a little cross sweep here and see the speed of this young man, Selvin Young.
Third down for Texas. Young, touchdown, his fourth of the year. And the celebration's begun in Austin. Look out 6th Street, here they come. Boy, this is a talented bunch. And the extra point is good. Right down the middle. Seven-12 remains in the ball game. The Longhorns lead Iowa State by 11. Texas puts an exclamation point on their lead, 21-10, and the Pontiac Drive summary, Ed, looks like this. What a drive that was.
And Cedric Benson and Selvin Young finishes it off, and that's the kind of drive that this Texas team needs. The offensive line has been banged and battered and bruised, and they're playing so well. 4 third down conversions on that drive, and the one very questionable fourth down conversion.
Wagner at the 5. Absolutely nowhere to run. Great special teams coverage by the Longhorns of Texas. Yeah. 21-10, 7:02 remaining. We'll be back. ABC Sports presentation of college football is brought to you by Pontiac, fuel for the soul, by Miller High Life. To live simply, proudly, boldly, manly, this is the High Life. And by the people of Allstate, you're in good hands with Allstate. Getting dark again in Austin, Texas. Bevo back on his feet after taking a little siesta. A few raindrops starting to fall again. Seneca Wallace has to make things happen now. Here's Whitfer. Tries to dance his way around a couple of defenders, but loses a couple of yards. Cedric Griffin holds on to him for the tackle. That's 5 catches for Whitford.
Sorry, Tim, I don't think that Iowa State can afford to huddle. I mean, the way that the clock was melted so well by Cedric Benson and the offensive line of Texas last time, I think that Dan McCarney needs to get into a hurry-up mode right now, down 11. This is a lot of time running off the clock between plays. I think they need to hurry it up.
This is a team that has moved up and down the field offensively, but not gotten many points. 10 points for as many times as they've been close. It's not right. Here's Wallace again. With time, plenty of time. Throws across the middle, incomplete. Dangerous pass, but it was to Danielson, and he couldn't hold on.
Well, it has been one of those games, hasn't it, Tim, for Iowa State? It just seemed to not be able to do is that little final push. Seneca Wallace, other than the interception, has rebounded nicely after the horrible outing last week against Oklahoma. But a couple of missed field goals, not being able to capitalize inside the 15-yard line is going to end up costing them.
They're bringing a blitz to Wallace, third down. They chase him out. And he throws it away. Then he's hit out of bounds, and a flag flies.
Well, I'm not sure if they're going to. I don't think they're going to get Corey Redding for that. They're going to get intentional grounding on Seneca Wallace. Even though he's outside of the pocket, he has to throw the ball past the line of scrimmage.
Intentional grounding on the offense. Penalty is lost it down at the spot of the foul. Brings up fourth down.
When they put this rule in a couple of years ago, the one thing they did a little bit different from the NFL was they said, listen, if you're going to throw it away, you at least have to attempt to get the ball down the field. And that's a great call by the official. There was no attempt by Seneca Wallace. He just dumps the ball out of his hand to try to not lose yardage. Proper call by the official on the spot.
So Tony Yelk standing back midway in the end zone.
Boy, and it looks like Texas is going to come after this one. 7 block kicks so far this year. Why not try to make it 8?
Remember, Nathan Vasher had those 2 returns earlier this year. This one's loose. Did it hit a Texas player?
No,
it hit somebody in the back.
Yeah, it hit an Iowa State player. It looked like Lane Danielson. He was going down, hit him right in the back of the head.
Dan McCartney's out on the field saying, hey, wait a minute, this is our ball. He said, hit the Texas guy. It hit Texas first, he said.
Ball was touched by the kicker.
Yeah.
At the 32-yard line. First down.
Oh, Dan's not buying it.
No, that's exactly what happened. Lane Danielson was running down from the bullet. Yelk didn't get off a beauty. He was expecting pressure, didn't get it. He kind of rushed his kick.
Here it is. Take a look.
Anderson right here in the middle. Hits him right in the back of the shoulder pads. Comes close to getting Rod Babers, but it doesn't matter. Once it's touched that kicking team,
it's exactly
going to be
right.
Your ball.
That's exactly right. And you can't blame Dan McCartney for fighting for it.
Nah. You sure can't, but that's the right call.
Ball's loose now. And Iowa State says they've got it. Young never got the handoff, it didn't look like. At least he never got the handle. And Leaders comes up with it.
Boy, that was a funky looking exchange between Sims and Young, wasn't it? It just never looked like. I don't think Selvin Young got his right elbow up high enough. He didn't make a big enough pocket. He didn't squeeze in the ball. Ball got put right in the pocket by Chris Sims. And the true freshman, Selvin Young, makes a true freshman mistake. That he's got to get that ball. That's just a missed handoff by him.
So Dan didn't have it right the first time and hit the Texas guy second, and he fumbled. Here's the pass completed to Montgomery. Montgomery's up to the 46-yard line. Iowa State now has to move with some urgency.
Yeah. And they're huddling. I don't get it. The clock is even less than it was before. We've had almost a minute go from the last time they started their possession, and they're still going to huddle. It's going to take them between 8 and 12 seconds to get this playoff. I think they've got to go to the no huddle.
5.5 minutes. Wallace throws over the middle, incomplete. This is where Seneca Wallace, the All-American, really has to pick up his play. He's been so special for Dan McCartney. We asked him, what is it about this kid?
He's got tremendous God-given ability. He's got a tremendous arm. He's got great feet. We call it sweet feet, which he does in the open field. But he believes he's a passer first. And a lot of times running backs or quarterbacks, they have those great feet and those great open field moves. They always want to run first, but Seneca can throw it first. He wants to, and he's been real effective for the most part on third and fourth down, the most critical downs on any field.
Well, the senior from Sacramento, California has to throw now, and he's got to be effective. Second down and 10 out of the shotgun. It was intended for Danielson. He couldn't hold on. It'll bring up a long third down.
Boy, Carl Reese, the defensive coordinator for Texas, has done such a nice job today giving Seneca Wallace so many different looks. That time, Texas has gone back to playing a little more zone coverage than they used to. They learned their lesson. Actually, go all the way back to the Holiday Bowl against Oregon a few years ago, what man coverage can do to you against some of these diverse offenses. And now Carl Reese in a position where he is ahead of the chains. He can just rush 4 and drop 7. Looks like he might bring pressure again, though.
Wallace in the second half is just 3 for 11, 27 yards. Has not been sharp at all. And this is an incompletion, or is it? Did he make the catch? Yes. First down. Lance Young with a terrific catch.
Well, it depends on the spot, Tim.
Well, I was like Pearson. Yeah. I thought it hit the ground.
They're calling it a catch, and Lance Young had to come back to get it. He is right up top working one-on-one. as he fights to come back to get this ball. Take a look, see if he caught it.
Had it.
Depends on the spot. Nathan Vasher there on the coverage.
First down. So a terrific catch by Lance Young.
And you got to go. You got to go. As soon as they set the chains, come on. Come on, Iowa State. Let's go. Get the play in. Get up to the line of scrimmage. Let's not waste any more of this clock down 11.
Now the clock starts to move. Under 5 minutes we go. Wallace steps up, throws a dart, and it's dropped by Danielson.
Well, you don't see that, do you? I mean, that's a dart, a really nice job of Seneca Wallace. We just mentioned, you know, listened to Dan McCarney talk about him being a passer first, and Wallace did a great job stepping up in the pocket and delivering this ball. That's as sure-handed a guy as you're going to see. Making a drop.
Well, I'm watching McCarney pace the sidelines. He is some kind of intense. Second down and 10. This ball is skipped to Montgomery. Hit the ground first.
These are really tough throws that Dan McCarney and his offensive coordinator, Steve Bricky. I mean, Wallace has the arm to make them. But those long hitches all the way across the field, I mean, they're on the right hash. That ball was thrown on a hitch all the way to the other side. I know he's got a great arm, but maybe some crossing routes. And now at third and 10, you're definitely in four down territory, I would think, at this juncture of the game.
I can't believe they're not showing more urgency than this. 4:41 to play. They're down to two plays. Unless they get the first. Going deep, overthrown. It was intended for Montgomery, but now that brings up fourth down and 10, and this is it.
Yeah. Iowa State, they didn't have to get all of it. They're in four down situation at this point of the game. And that ball floated away on Seneca Wallace. The pressure was not the problem. And Dan McCarney now stuck with the make or break play of the game. I still think you want Seneca Wallace to be able to move around a little bit, not frozen in the pocket.
Fourth down, they need 10. Throwing a timing pattern to the corner. Incomplete.
Well, we saw this earlier, the fade route in the first half. When they needed a touchdown, going for the field goal, you know, they had to go for the field goal that they ended up missing. And again, they only give it a one shot. And I think Seneca Wallace, his talents give him more than one shot.
4:31 to play. The Cyclones may be out of time. .431 to play. Texas with a 21-10 lead now takes over on first down. After Iowa State was unable to get the first. So here comes Sims. He'll try to melt the clock. This is Robin. Brett Robin with his first carry of the game. So it'll bring up second down and long. Time permitting, we'll have the Thrifty postgame report with John Saunders and Terry Bowden. A lot of great games today. Penn State, Ohio State, Florida State, Notre Dame, Texas, Iowa State. Right now the Longhorns leading 21-10.
Well, and I can understand why Brett Robin, well, take that back. I can understand why Cedric Benson's not in the game. You don't want to get him hurt. But I would think Selvin Young would be your back right now, not Brett Robin.
All right, I think he heard you.
I take it back. And now Iowa State in a position where they may start have to think about taking their timeouts.
All Well, we'd like to welcome those of you who've been watching the Penn State-Ohio State game. Tim Brandt, along with Ed Cunningham and Samantha Ryan. Our score, Texas 21, Iowa State 10. Longhorns have the ball, trying to melt the clock. This game's significant, not only in the Big 12, but possibly the BCS at-large game. Both of these teams in the last 2 weeks have lost to Oklahoma. Last week, it was Iowa State. The week before that, it was Texas. So this game is huge. And the Cyclones take a timeout. Ohio State beating Penn State 13-7. Zach Mills with those picks could have been a difference maker.
Interesting to see the injury to Maurice Claret, how serious that is. But the story has been Cedric Benson, 199 yards today, creeping close to his career high. I don't think he's getting it. I believe he's done for the day.
83,000 here at Memorial Stadium today, and they don't believe this one's over just yet. We'll be back.
Questioning what they've been doing up front. Coming into the game, they've only been averaging 136 yards a game and 110 more today because of that offensive line and Cedric Benson.
Well, Benson set all those freshman records last year with 1,053 yards and 12 touchdowns and having a great year this year, the 19-year-old from Midland, Texas. Brent Robin, the ball carrier again. He's a junior. He's a dependable, versatile fourth-year back. Just trying to melt the clock, shorten the game, and get out of here.
Timeout, Iowa State. Second charge timeout of the half.
Texas has won 16 home wins in a row, the fourth longest active streak in the nation. And the Longhorns are trying to make it 17 straight.
And it looks like Mac Brown will go to 20-0 at Texas when they rush for over 200 yards in a game. I mean, it's not that unusual to rush for that many yards and win all those games, but that's a lot of games when you go back with Ricky Williams and now Cedric Benson. They're starting to get a legacy here going with great backs under Mac Brown at Texas.
Give Chris Sims some, 16 of 23 today, 141 yards. He was haunted by those three interceptions versus Colorado and the four he threw against Oklahoma. They put a lot of pressure on him, but he came up big last week and again today.
And then for Seneca Wallace, a lot of it, the question coming into today's game was how he would rebound against after that horrible outing against Oklahoma with only four completions for 40 yards. He played very well early and he just struggled here in the second half. But you can't put it all on him. Lane Danielson had a drop. He didn't get quite the protection, and I didn't think that they always put him in the best position to be successful today.
You know, fans here in Austin were so fired up after the 98 season with the Cotton Bowl win and the Heisman with Ricky Williams, and then Mac Brown got that number one recruiting class in the country. Their expectations are high. They want that national championship back. It's been a long time. Here's Robin straight ahead. Be about a yard short of the first, so it'll bring up fourth down.
Iowa State timeout, third and final one of the half.
Well, let's take a look at the alumni report. Try to do this every weekend. This is fun. We bring back some memories. Ricky Williams, the tailback in the late 90s. Look at that, 6,279 yards and 72 touchdowns. Special.
I will never forget the run he had against Texas A&M that sealed the game and sealed him winning the Heisman and broke the all-time NCAA rushing record. And Cedric Benson in high school those years, that was the guy that he has modeled his life after.
At practice on Thursday, standing on the sidelines and talking to Mac Brown, and somebody came up to him and handed a cell phone, said, hey, coach, there's somebody on the line that says they won a Heisman. It was Ricky Williams calling to talk to Mac, and then he took the phone and gave it to Cedric Benson, and Ricky Williams talked to Cedric for a while.
And that's one thing Mac Brown has been so good with here at Texas. Very quickly brought Darryl Royal back into the football family, wants him involved as much as possible, and all of the facilities that he has had a hand in building for Texas football, and there's been a lot of them, a great weight room and everything. He said, I want state-of-the-art, but there better be a nod to the tradition of Texas. And you walk through these buildings and the things that they show you, the great tradition built by Darryl Royal and the people before him. He's just really sharp in making sure that these young men know the university that they're playing for has a great history.
Chris Sims, they got after him a little bit this afternoon with boos when he took a sack and another time when he threw an interception. And he's been solid through and through. You know, Chris Sims takes so much heat. And it's because of the two Oklahoma games, I'm sure. He snaps back occasionally, but I'll tell you what, you put a magnifying glass on a guy in the spotlight and it starts to burn. I don't blame him. He's quality quarterback.
Well, you know, a lot of people are talking about what's going to happen with the NFL draft. And you were talking to Gil Brandt before the game, and he said, you know, people are going to be surprised. He's going to go a lot higher in the draft than people would think. He's got a lot of ability. I think there's some things he can work on technique-wise. He doesn't take great drops. He still needs to work out some of his kinks, but he has a lot of ability.
Well, the Cyclones take over on downs. Here's Seneca Wallace needing a miracle now. Throws to Whitford. That's complete. Not enough for the first. They pick up seven. It'll bring up second down and three. Clock continues to move at 2:40.
Well, and the hard part for Iowa State, they had to burn all three of their timeouts to save this clock for the offense. Now you got to start thinking about throwing sideline routes and getting out of bounds or getting first down yardage so it stops.
Wallace steps up, throws incomplete, broken up nicely by DJ Derek Johnson.
Wallace's pass was intended for number 82, Lane Daniels.
Derek Johnson, a guy who, with all those great linebackers they had here for the last 3 years, worked his way into the lineup last year. Not even starting, he had over 70 tackles. Was the co-Big 12 defensive freshman of the year with Tommy Harris of Oklahoma. He's a big, smooth athlete.
Flags fly everywhere. You know, before the Oklahoma game, Iowa State averaged 40 points a game in the seven previous outings.
Well, the ball was dead. False start on the offense. 5 yards, remains third down.
Today, only 10 points for Iowa State. Last week, they gained only 60 yards.
Well, you hit it right on the head a minute ago, though, when you were saying it's just been so fresh. They've moved the ball today. They struggled a little bit here in the second half, but the statistics show them, you would think they would have more than 10 points, and they should.
Third down and 8 for Seneca Wallace. Out of the gun. Wallace drills one to the sidelines, almost picked off, and then caught by Lance Young.
Go. Don't stand around and admire your work. You made a nice play on a ball that should have been intercepted, but let's go. Get up to the line of scrimmage.
Favors thought he had the pick, but it brings up fourth down and 3. Wallace again. Backside pressure. Steps up and throws it over the head of the intended receiver, Whitford. And that'll do it.
And it was part of this great recruiting class that Mack Brown put together this year. Brian Pickroll, a true freshman, defensive end, who had that backside pressure opposite of Corey Redding.
I love Brian Pickroll.
I knew that was coming. You always like to get your Brian song reference in, don't you?
1:53 to play in what has been a cloudy, drizzly, cold day in Austin, Texas.
And this is when I was playing my favorite formation that could ever be called, the victory formation.
Folks, coming up tomorrow, the competitive figure skating season begins. Michelle Kwan and rising star Jenny Kirk head the field for the USA. Smart ones skate America tomorrow at 1 Eastern, 3 Pacific, right here on ABC Sports Championship Television. 1:28 left as the clock continues to move.
Things don't get any easier for Iowa State. They were at Oklahoma last week, at Texas this week. We've got a couple of games coming up against ranked opponents at Kansas State and at Colorado. It's not going to be tough down the stretch for Iowa State, or not easy, excuse me, for Iowa State down the stretch.
Today's Chevrolet's players of the game. Jamie Billups, 9 tackles, pass interception. And Mr. Benson, who played an outstanding game. 30 carries, 199 yards, 2 touchdowns and a fumble. In recognition of their effort, Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund.
Next week, Texas goes to Nebraska, then Baylor at Texas Tech and Texas A&M. They play like they played today with the running game. They'll have a chance to win all of those, but they're going to need some help here in the Southern Division.
Well, this region, next week on ABC, we'll get the Colorado-Oklahoma game. So you'll find out if the Sooners can stumble or whether they continue their charge toward what could be another national championship appearance. Final tick off the clock. And this one's in the books. Texas will go to 7-1, 3-1 in the Big 12 South. Iowa State falls to 6-3 and 3-2 in the conference. Well, that'll do it. Once again, the final score, Texas 21, Iowa State 10. ABC Sports is online at ESPN.com. Keyword ABC Sports. Monday night at 9 Eastern Time, NFC East Rivals Clash as the New York Giants battle the Philadelphia Eagles on ABC's NFL Monday Night Football. Coming up, the Thrifty Postgame Show in Manhattan with John and Terry. Brett Cunningham and Sam Ryan, I'm Tim Brandt saying so long.
Only 30.